Let's scan some of these things here. I know what that is. Super missile. Alright, I want to scan you. Planet Zebus. It's just basically... Zebus is inhospitable to most bioforms. The world was considered unremarkable until it became base for space pirate forces. Earth core, subterranean construction. Yeah, it makes a... Yes, I know, it's right behind me. Where is it? What am I looking for? Twin Tula, not what I'm looking for. There it is. No. There. You search planet Talon 4. Ecosystem studies indicate Talon 4 was a biological paradise. Prior to the impact of extraterrestrial object, what remains of the biosphere is slowly fading due to the exposure of phazon radiation. At current rate of decay, Talon 4 will be a barren class 8 or 13 wasteland within approximately 25 years. There's the marking up there on the top right where the impact crater is. Yeah, this one's been... This planet's been, changing a lot lately. Yes. Safe station is right there. I'm just gonna use it to heal, though. No. Not gonna make the mistake of saving and having to redo this over again should anything be wrong with the video. I've already done that a number of times. Ow! You're in my way. Control tower. Why did that one just suddenly die? Hire communicate analyze. Main research facility located. I'm kind of in it. Just so you know. Research core. Yeah. I wonder what they're researching. I mean, they have the one facility near the crater to mine the phazon. They have the orbital research station surrounding the planet to research mutating bioforms that can survive in space for military purposes. Why do they feel the need to have yet another research station up near the pole of the planet, in the cold? Maybe it's under the pole of the planet, maybe it's just like on a really high mountain top, I don't know. I think it's the pole. We'll find out here in a minute. Here it is. Metroids. Metroids are extremely weak against cold. So... Oh shit. researching them in a cold climate is ideal. These Metroids are a little bit different. Dominant species of planet SF388. Metroids can suck the life force out of living things. A Metroid will latch onto its prey and drain energy, growing large as it does. The only way to shake and attach Metroid is thermal. Oh, yeah. This is a regular Metroid here. Why is it glowing? Oh, and they made it easier to kill Metroids in this game since you're going to encounter them a lot more often. You don't have to freeze them and missile them. Plus, I don't even have an ice beam, so that wouldn't be possible. There's something I want to read. Pirate data. The reconstruction of Geoform 187, codenamed Ridley, was recently completed. After his defeat on Zuba's command ordered a number of metagenetic improvements for him. Though aggressive, we were able to implement these changes in a cycle. The metamorphosis was painful, but quite successful in the end. Early tests indicate a drastic increase in strength, mobility, and offensive capability. Cybernetic modules and armor have been added as well. We believe our creation, now called Meta Ridley, will become the mainstay of our security force, a job he will certainly relish. Basically, the only way they could keep Ridley alive after his defeat on Zebus was to turn him into a cyborg. I'm sure he was none too happy. I can imagine what he was doing to the researchers as they were putting on the more painful aspects of the procedure. Fire data. Confidence in high regarding Phazon applications, we now know enough about Phazon to begin combining it with space pirate DNA. Coding for this venture will be Project Helix. Preliminary studies indicate that Phazon infusion could produce radical new pirate genomes. Benevolent mutation levels are high in current test subjects. Phazon madness is a concern, but refinements in the infusion process should reduce or neutralize the odds of mental degeneration. They're taking this Phazon and they're putting it inside everything. Metroids, animals themselves. They're just power hungry little bastards. Turn on that elevator. I'll take that. Metroid dissection continues to provide more questions than answers. Our research teams have isolated the energy conduits that run from the invasive twin mandibles to the energy core in the creature's quadrupedal nucleus. But the manner in which a Metroid actually extracts the life force from its prey remains an utter mystery. The victim does not lose blood or any other vital fluids, and yet the Metroid extracts energy. Identifying this energy is our central problem. It takes no physical form, and yet without it, the victim dies. We will continue to research this matter, as the isolation of this life-giving essence could be the key to our ascendance. Basically what they just said is Metroids don't suck out your blood, they don't suck out anything else, they suck out your soul, pretty much. Only something designed by the Chozo would be able to do that. Studies of metrobiology continue, though with limited progress. It seems likely that we will be much more successful using the Metroids for our means, rather than trying to reproduce their powers. If they could be adequately tamed, we would have no need of a proper understanding of their metabolism. A small force of disciplined Metroids could wipe out entire armies, and once we find a way to shield them from cold containment weapons, they would be invincible. Furthermore, if we could then harvest the energy they'd consumed, we would have a near limitless source of power at our disposal. That's why the pirates wanted the Metroids so badly. And that's why I took over Zebus. Because that's where they were developing the Metroids. Chozo. You're a beetle, right? Why do I scan you twice? Oh, you're ice beetle. That's a little different, I guess. sympathetic. Open. Thank you. Why does it gotta be so dark? Yeah, that's what this research station is for. Metroid. Okay. Central tank control unit connection. Oh. Okay. I know it's that. I know what that is. I just need to get down there. This thunderstorm better not knock on my power. That was a loud crack of thunder. I'm getting just a little worried. Ouch! Stop shooting at me. Thermal visor acquired. Infrared. Okay, what's going on? Oh, we lose power. Awesome. Well, hopefully I only lose power in the game and not... I can see in the dark now. Ow, oh. I remember on one of my tries through this, I think it was the try where the video quality was screwed up, I almost died because I completely ignored the pirates. I just wanted to get out of the research facility, and because of that, I let them hit me a lot more than I should have, and I almost died. I'm going to try and not make that same mistake, even though I'm trying to get through this, get as far as I can through this game in as little time as possible. I am going to take my time and kill everything in my path. Because I'm not saving this time. Should I die, I will go back much farther than just... Yeah, I pretty much have to start all over again. And that's not fun. You know, something so threatening. Supposedly threatening. This game are kind of, and the Metroids are kind of like, they're kind of pathetic. Haha, I can't stand the waving, can ya? Open. Thank you. More pirates. You know what? I'm gonna let the Metroids loose. I'll let them take on the pirates. Hopefully this plan doesn't backfire. Oh shoot, there's a Metroid right there. Run! That's a missile tank up there, isn't it? Yep. I'll come back to that later. I'm making that mistake again, aren't I? I'm just running past them without fighting them. I swear I thought I wasn't going to do that. You know what? I was confident Metroid to do all the fighting for me, so...